Today we're going to cover 5 basic hypergraph operations: weak vertex deletion, weak edge deletion, strong vertex deletion, strong edge deletion, and edge contraction. Let's begin with weak vertex deletion. Basically, weak deletion of a vertex is when we remove a vertex from the hypergraph without removing anything else. Here's an example of weak deletion of vertex A in this hypergraph. More formally, if we have a hypergraph H with vertex set V and edge set E, then weak deleting a vertex X from H means removing X from V and removing X from each edge in E that was incident to X. This produces a new hypergraph, H minus X. Let's find the result of weak deletion of vertex C from this hypergraph. First, find our new vertex set. It will be A, B, D, E, F, G. Next, find our new edge set based on the original edge set. E sub 1 does not contain vertex C, so we can leave it unchanged in our new edge set. E sub 2 does contain vertex C, so remove it and add the new E sub 2 to our hypergraph. Finally, E sub 3 also contains vertex C, so remove it and add the new E sub 3 to our hypergraph. This is the resulting hypergraph, H minus C. Let's move on to weak deletion of edges. Weak deletion of edges means we remove an edge from the hypergraph, leaving all other objects unchanged. Here is an example of weak deleting edge E sub 1. More formally, weak deleting an edge Y from a hypergraph means removing Y from the edge set of that hypergraph. This produces a new hypergraph, H minus Y, with the same vertex set but without edge Y. Let's find the result of weak deletion of edge E sub 2 from this hypergraph. First, the vertex set of our new hypergraph will be the same as the original vertex set. Next, the edge set of our new hypergraph will be our original edge set, excluding E sub 2. This is our resulting hypergraph, H minus E sub 2. Let's move on to strong deletion of vertices. Strong vertex deletion is when we remove a vertex as well as all the edges that contained it. In other words, we weakly delete all edges incident to a vertex, and then weakly delete our vertex. What remains is the set of vertices minus the vertex we deleted, along with only the edges that are entirely between the vertices that we did not delete. Here's an example of strongly deleting vertex D from this hypergraph. The result of strongly deleting a vertex X from a hypergraph H is a new hypergraph, H minus X, where we note the minus means strong vertex deletion. This new hypergraph has vertex set V minus X and edge set E minus E of X, where E of X is the set of edges incident to X. As another example, let's strongly delete vertex C from the hypergraph shown here. First, identify the edges that vertex C is incident to. Those would be edges E sub 2 and E sub 3. Next, weakly delete those edges. Finally, weakly delete vertex C. This is our result. Now, let's move on to strong edge deletion. Strong edge deletion is when we remove an edge and all vertices incident to it. In other words, strong deleting an edge Y means we weakly delete all vertices incident to Y, and then we weakly delete edge Y. As an example, let's strongly delete edge E sub 3 from this hypergraph. First, identify the vertices that are contained by E sub 3. That would be vertices B, C, and E. Next, weakly delete those vertices from our hypergraph. Finally, weakly delete E3 from our hypergraph. This is the result. Moving on, let's look at the relationship between deletions and the incidence matrix with a fixed ordering of vertices and edges. Let's use this hypergraph along with weak vertex deletion to demonstrate. We'll order our columns from least to greatest according to the subscripts of the edges, and we'll order our rows alphabetically. First, find its incidence matrix. Feel free to pause the video and do this yourself. Here it is. Now, here's the result of weak deleting vertex A from this hypergraph. Can you find a new incidence matrix with the same ordering? Here it is. Notice how it's the same as the old incidence matrix, except that the row corresponding to A has been deleted. That's the effect that weak vertex deletion has on the incidence matrix. It deletes the row corresponding to the deleted vertex. Now, what happens if we weakly delete an edge? Well, let's weakly delete edge E1 in this hypergraph. Here's the incidence matrix of the new hypergraph. Notice that the new incidence matrix is found from the original by deleting the column associated with the weakly deleted edge. That's the effect the weak edge deletion has on the incidence matrix. It deletes the column corresponding to the deleted edge. Next, let's look at strong vertex deletion. To demonstrate, let's strongly delete vertex C from this hypergraph. That means we need to weakly delete the edges incident to C and weakly delete C. Here's the result. And here's the incidence matrix of the result. Notice that it could be formed from the original incidence matrix by finding the columns that have a 1 in their intersection with the row corresponding to C, deleting those columns, and then deleting the row that corresponds to C. That's the effect strong vertex deletion has on the incidence matrix. It deletes each column with a 1 in the row corresponding to the deleted vertex, and then deletes the row corresponding to the deleted vertex. Finally, let's look at strong edge deletion. As an example, let's strongly delete edge E2 from this hypergraph. Here's the result, along with its incidence matrix. Notice how the new incidence matrix can be formed from the original by deleting each row with a 1 in the intersection with the column corresponding to E2, followed by deleting the column corresponding to E2. That's the effect of strong edge deletion on the incidence matrix. It deletes each row with a 1 in the column corresponding to the deleted edge, and then deletes the column corresponding to the deleted edge. If you notice, there's a symmetry in how edge and vertex deletion affects the incidence matrix. Also, remember that the incidence matrix of the dual hypergraph is the transpose of the incidence matrix of the original hypergraph. Also, if we remove a row from a matrix and then take the transpose, it's the same thing as taking the transpose and then removing that row's corresponding column. So if you remember that weak edge deletion corresponds to removing a column from the incidence matrix, then if we have a hypergraph S formed by weak deletion of an edge Y from a hypergraph H, we can say that the dual of S is the same as the hypergraph dual of H minus Y, where the minus in this case means weak vertex deletion of the vertex in the dual of H corresponding to edge Y. To demonstrate, weakly delete edge E1 in this hypergraph, and then take its dual. Notice how it's the same as the dual of the original with the operation of weak deletion of the vertex corresponding to edge E1. Essentially, weak edge deletion in the original hypergraph corresponds to weak vertex deletion in the dual, and it's also true that weak vertex deletion in the original corresponds to weak edge deletion in the dual. The same is true for the strong version of these deletions. This all comes from the fact that incidence matrices of duals are transposes of each other, and that edge and vertex deletions operate in dual ways with respect to the rows and columns of the incidence matrix. As a challenge, I encourage you to think about the effect of edge and vertex deletion on the incidence graph of a hypergraph, and share your findings in the comments. If you're not familiar with incidence graphs, feel free to check out my earlier video introducing them. As the last concept in this video, let's look at edge contraction. If we have a hypergraph H and some edge in it, Y, then a contraction of edge Y is when we replace the vertices that were incident to Y by a single vertex, which we will make incident to the set of all edges that shared a vertex with Y. And finally, we weakly delete Y from our hypergraph. If you recall from graph theory, an edge contraction works the same way. We delete the edge and merge the endpoints, of which there are two, into a single vertex, incident to any edge that was adjacent to our contracted edge. To demonstrate hypergraph edge contraction, let's contract the edge E2 in the following hypergraph. First, list the edges that E2 shares a vertex with. They are E1 and E4. Also, we should list the vertices that are incident to E2. That would be C, D, and G. To perform the contraction, we merge these vertices into a single vertex. Let's call it X. And we make sure that X is incident to all the edges that shared a vertex with E2 originally. Then, we weakly delete E2 from the hypergraph. This is the result of contracting E2. So what's the effect of edge contraction on the incidence graph of a hypergraph? To demonstrate, here's the incidence graph of our example, and here's the incidence graph of the hypergraph resulting from the contraction of edge E2. Essentially, what occurred to the incidence graphs was the ordinary graph notion of vertex identification, or merging, of the vertices adjacent to E2, which are C, D, and G, followed by the deletion of E2. As another exercise, can you describe in the comments the effects of edge contraction on the incidence matrix? To finish the video, let's do a quick recap. Weak deletion of a vertex is when we remove that vertex from the vertex set of the hypergraph, as well as from any of the edges it was incident to. Weak deletion of an edge is when we remove that edge from the edge set of the hypergraph. Strong deletion of a vertex is when we weakly delete all of its incident edges as well as weakly delete that vertex. Strong deletion of an edge is when we weakly delete all its incident vertices as well as the edge itself. Finally, edge contraction means we merge all the vertices it was incident to into a single vertex contained by the set of all edges adjacent to our contracted edge, combined with the weak deletion of our contracted edge. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. Have a great day.